My flamenco friends, welcome to the temple of flamenco. Before I go to say what I want to say, this recording, this is the singer, El Sevillano. Cornelio Ricardo. And this is another one. This is the last one that they made in 1969. And these recordings are, well, I think, the 40s. The former century, the 40s. I don't know, 1943. But it's very curious because El Sevillano is singing a Solearas. It's the only Solearas that they recorded. And normally he was singing bulerías, the canción, and fandangos, and milongas, and farruca. But one day, Enrique Morente said to me, El Sevillano, he knows everything, all the songs. And he proved it with the Solearas. And the Joaquín de la Paula, he lived in Alcalá de Guadira, if I'm not wrong. And Nino Ricardo in the introduction is playing a falseta, and there's also there La Nino Spanus encouraging. And he said to Nino Ricardo, Ole Maestro Patiño. Yeah, it's also Maestro Patiño. That means that Ricardo was playing falsetas of Maestro Patiño. So, truly, Ricardo, I discovered falsetas from Maestro Patiño and other, also from Javier Molina. That was Ricardo in the beginning. He was still young. It was very interesting because Maestro Patiño never recorded. So, that's very good stuff. And, well, what I want to say, they wrote a book about me. Un payo entre los flamencos. And it is written by Pablo San Nicasio Ramos. Good guitarist, good writer. And well, this is Spanish, that's the problem. You can buy it, but this is Spanish. Maybe one day it will be in translation, in English. I don't know. The cover is this picture. This picture was taken by the daughter of Paco de Lucía. When I met Paco de Lucía, many years ago in his house in Madrid in Calle Cambrils, number 12. It's funny, this picture, this photograph. And they used it for the cover. So you can buy it. Amazon, I don't know, if you want. There are people, they're not very difficult Spanish. And the people that I'm talking, I met in my life of flamenco, can of course Nino Ricardo, Enrique Morente, but many people like Juito Valderrama, Curro Marena, or the people that I mentioned, like Manolo Huelva. I never met Manolo Huelva. But yes, Miguel Vargas, I work with him, and Mariela Marrura, very good singer from America, I think of Florida. And the name is Maria La Marrura, artistic name. I forgot her original name. Like Silver,
I think she's still alive.
What I can say, so Pablo has given a description of all the artists that I met and mentioned. Vicente Amigo. So that's all. And about my book, Pablo San Nicasio Ramos also wrote a book before, Contra las Cuerdas. This is a book, very interesting, claro. What can I say? It is in Spanish. But he had an interview that I made with Paco de Lucía in 71, many years ago. And I was living in Madrid, I was near Ricardo, and I recorded an interview, entrevista, and he say, incluye entrevista inédita a Paco de Lucía, means they didn't know about it. So when I told to him, to Paulo, well, I made, you're writing a book about flamencos, guitarist, against the strings. Is he, yes, well, I have still somewhere an interview with Paco de Lucía. He said, well, please give it to me. I said, of course. And I sent him a copy of the cassette. So, it's also in Spanish. He wrote two books, Contra las Cuerdas, and then this book. Well, my friends, this is all. I hope you enjoyed, and let's go on. I go to talk about more things, especially about Paco de Lucía. Well, let's see. Have a nice day. Thank you. Thank you very much. Muchas gracias.
Yo a ti te culpo. Eso sería esa mala.
Seguirías, ¿eh? Great singer.